Collisions between aircraft and wildlife, as well as engine ingestion of wildlife, cause millions of dollars in damage and pose a serious threat to human safety. And these strikes are on the rise. Three main factors are driving the increase in wildlife strikes. First, many large bird and mammal populations have grown over the last few decades, including Canada geese, wild turkeys, red-tailed hawks, and white-tailed deer. In addition, air traffic has increased markedly since 1980, and today's commercial aircraft have fewer engines, which are also quieter. The good news is that the Federal Aviation Administration has been implementing and refining a wildlife hazard mitigation program to combat this problem. Tools such as wildlife hazard assessments are helping to identify and minimize risks of aircraft-wildlife collisions. This, in turn, can save lives of both humans and animals, as well as repair costs and damaged aircraft downtime. Certified airport wildlife biologists with professional training specifically in airport wildlife hazard management must conduct these wildlife hazard assessments. Among the threats they look for are signs that animals inhabit the area, such as burrows along perimeter fences and near runways, as well as the more obvious signs, such as birds perching on and feeding near perimeter fences. Aviation officials also must concern themselves with wildlife outside airport grounds. Some habitats, human activities, and operations within the vicinity of an airport can attract wildlife and increase the risk of strikes. Nearby farming operations, golf courses, wastewater treatment plants, landfills, woody debris piles, and wetlands can all attract wildlife. Among the most hazardous bird species are the snow goose, the black vulture, northern pintail, turkey vulture, and Canada goose. Among the most hazardous mammal species are the mule deer, white-tailed deer, and coyote, along with other species such as the black-tailed jackrabbit, black-tailed prairie dog, and Mexican ground squirrel. SWCA has several FAA-qualified airport wildlife biologists who can conduct wildlife hazard assessments. And SWCA provides a full range of natural resource consulting services for airport projects, with the ultimate goal of reducing wildlife-caused aviation hazards. For more information on the aviation-related services we offer, visit our website.